In this MetaMask tutorial, I'm going to show you how to connect MetaMask to Harmony.One network, so you can send funds to your MetaMask wallet and make transactions with much lower fees compared to other blockchains right now. I will then show you how to connect your MetaMask to popular DeFi apps like ViperSwap to swap and earn other tokens there. And as a bonus, towards the end of the video, I will show you how to earn some passive income using your crypto assets. So make sure to stick with me to the end. But for now, let's get started. Firstly, you'll need to open up your MetaMask extension on your computer. But if you haven't set up MetaMask yet, then you can go to metamask.io and click on download now and follow the steps to create your account. But if you need more help on this part, then I have a full MetaMask tutorial, which I'll link in a description for you. So check that out if you need some more help. But for now in this tutorial, I assume that you have MetaMask set up. So you can go to your extension, go over to this three dots here and click on expand view. This will take you to your MetaMask dashboard. The first important note that I want to tell you is that you don't need a secondary wallet in order to interact on the Harmony.One blockchain. You can use this exact same wallet address interchangeably between all these different blockchains, including Binance, Matic, Phantom, etc. You just have to know that a coin that belongs in one chain will not show up and does not exist in another chain. You can see here on the Matic chain, I have 0.004 Matic, and on Phantom, I have 41.99 Phantom. But on Ethereum, I have no tokens at all. But in the end, if this gets too confusing for you and you would rather use a different wallet for each of the blockchains, you can do that as well by clicking here and then go to create an account, and you can have a new account set up in 2 seconds. And you can import an account if you have already previously created one. And one more critical thing that I need to mention while we're on the topic of crypto wallets is that I always recommend you to use a hardware wallet. And MetaMask supports Ledger and a Trezor wallet. And I have both of these and I would recommend both of them. But if you don't have one yet and you're looking to get one, then I have a full in-depth review and tutorial on both of these hardware wallets. So to help you out, I'll leave links to these videos and the actual products in the description below. Now let's get on to actually connecting MetaMask to Harmony.One blockchain. And we're going to guide you through this with two different methods. So method one, you click here and go to custom RPC. You can see here there's 5 blank boxes that you must fill out. And so from this article here, which is on Harmony.One's official website, this is the information that you'll need to paste in. So I'll scroll up and copy and paste each one of these one by one. And I'll leave a copy of this text in the description for you as well, if you just want to quickly copy it from there. And a quick note is that for the RPC, we need to select this one. And for the shard, we need to select the 01. So this is what you should have pasted in. And now click on save. And now we can go back to our dashboard. And you can see our main token is now the one token. And our Harmony.One mainnet has been connected successfully. So now let me show you the second method, which I think is a lot easier to do, but I'll leave that choice up to you. So now I will delete this original RPC that I created. And you will have to go to a website called chainlist.org. And this is an aggregation website of all the different information for all the blockchains available right now. So from the search networks box, we will type in Harmony, and we want to choose this one, as this is the chain ID of Shard 0, which is what we want. So you click on Connect Wallet, and now click Add to MetaMask. A window will pop up and will get you to confirm this information. So you can see that this is exactly the same as on Harmony.One's website. So now we click on approve and click switch network. And now if we go back to our MetaMask, you can see the Harmony mainnet shard 0 is here for you. So from what I just showed you, you can definitely see that method 2 is much easier and quicker, and there's less chance of making a mistake by copying and pasting all these different values. If you're finding tips like this helpful so far, you can thank me by hitting that like button and subscribe to my channel if you want more of these videos. Now the next step is to verify that the blockchain we added is correct. And we can do this by funding our account with some small amounts of tokens. And I also have two methods for transferring your funds to the Harmony.One blockchain. So the first method is to use a centralized exchange, and one that I use personally myself a lot and recommend because they have so many altcoins available is Kucoin. So you can see from the withdrawal page that you can directly transfer your Harmony.One tokens to any crypto wallet. And we're going to transfer it to our MetaMask wallet here. But first, I'll need to buy some One tokens from Kucoin. And if you need to do the same, then I have a sign up link for Kucoin in the description, which you can get some discount on the fees for. So check that out if you don't have an account yet. So now I'm just going to purchase $10 worth of One coin as a test, and I want it as soon as possible. So I'm just going to click on market. type in $10 and click on buy one. And that's it. I've purchased my one token, and you can see here I was able to get 170.817 of this token. So now we can go back to the withdrawal page, refresh it, and then transfer it from our trading account to our main account. Click confirm. I agree that you understand the risks and click on continue. And now for our wallet address, this is the most important part, and it's the most unique out of any other blockchains that I've encountered. Because normally you would just simply copy this address here and paste it into the address to transfer your crypto tokens, right? But for Harmony, this is not the way to go. You have to go and open up their blockchain to get Harmony's own address. So for every Ethereum address you have here, there's another version of the Harmony address. So I'll show you what I mean. You can go to the three dots here and click on View in Explorer, or you can simply open up Explorer.Harmony.One, and then in this search bar, you can copy your Ethereum-based address here and paste it in there. And it will show up here, your Harmony One address. And you can flick back to the Ethereum address by clicking here, and there's our actual address, 83C83C, and they match. But I'll just show you what I mean. If I copy the Ethereum address here and paste it into this wallet address, Kucoin's gonna warn me and say that this is the wrong wallet address type. So what I need to do, and the correct way of doing this, is to click on one, and this is my version of the Harmony One's wallet address. Copy this. It should always start with the word one, O-N-E. Go back to Kucoin, paste that in, and now it shows up no problem. This is a very important thing to make sure you get right. So now I'm happy to transfer all, click on max, and now I'm gonna confirm it. Click on confirm withdrawal, put in the password and the codes required, and click on submit. And if we scroll down, you can see my transaction is on its way. And now you can go back to your MetaMask account, give it a couple of minutes, and my 169.811 tokens should arrive. And there it is. All my one tokens have just arrived successfully. So now let's move on to the second method. This method is most suitable for you if you want to transfer your existing tokens from the Ethereum blockchain or the Binance Smart Chain. Instead of using a centralized exchange like KuCoin or Binance like I showed you in method one. So for this method, you'll need to go to Bridge.Harmony.One, and this is Harmony One's official Bridge app. So you can see here, we can select Binance or Ethereum as our starting spot. But in this example, I'm going to use Binance, as Ethereum has much higher fees and is not really feasible at the moment with their $40 or $50 transactions. So I select Binance and then click on this MetaMask button here, then choose the wallet you want to make the transfer from, click Next, click on Connect. Now the next thing you have to do is to go to MetaMask and change from the Harmony One mainnet to your Binance Smart Chain, or if you're transferring from Ethereum, then go to Ethereum here. So I'll click on Binance now, and you can see I have three USDC, so I'm just going to transfer a dollar in this example. So now on the left hand side of the screen, we want to choose the BEP20 token, and in this box we want to type in USDC, and that's the token we're going to transfer. And for the amount here, it have to be one. Sometimes if your available balance does not show up, you may need to refresh the page and try again, which I just did, and it's working now. So we scroll down one more time, and I'm going to use the same MetaMask address, so click on that, but make sure that your last three or four digits is correct. And now we click on continue. And I'm happy to approve this amount, so I'll click on continue again. Read this about the fees and make sure you're happy with it. So it's gonna cost me 26 cents. I'm okay with that, so I'll click on confirm. And now a window on MetaMask will pop up, and you're gonna be charged more fees here. So you can see it's not much of a difference, but it's still more expensive than doing it on KuCoin. And now we click on confirm. And now we just have to wait a minute or so for this transaction to be completed. And there it is, success. My funds should have now arrived, and it's taken a total of 2 minutes to do. So let's go and check on MetaMask, see if our USDC has arrived correctly. So we go back to MetaMask, change this back to the Harmony mainnet, and now we have to go and add our USDC token. And the best way of doing it is clicking on this three dot here and then go to our Explorer again. And you can see here from our one account, we can fetch tokens. Click on it, let it load, click here again, and there's our USD coin. So we click there, and we want to convert this contract address to the Ethereum-based address. So we click on ETH, and then copy this contract address, go back to our MetaMask, click on Add Tokens, paste that address in there, and now you can see our USDC is coming up. Click Next, and then click on Add Tokens. And we go back, and you can see here our one USDC has arrived correctly. And now that we have some tokens on MetaMask, you can go ahead and swap for other tokens on the Harmony One blockchain. And one of the main decentralized exchange on this blockchain right now is ViperSwap. So if you type in viper.exchange, it should take you to this page where it'll log you in here automatically with your MetaMask account. But if it doesn't, then you can click here and connect from there. Now I'll show you an example of swapping the tokens on ViperSwap here. So let's say as an example, I just want to swap two of my one tokens into another token. So we select a token here, and let's say I just want to have one USDT. So that's showing me the rate I'm going to get. If I'm happy with that, you just click on swap, click confirm swap, and now pay the gas fees. And you can see here the gas fee is not even a fraction of 1 cent, which is crazy low. And that's why I believe these blockchains like Harmony One and Matic Network is a really good scaling solution for Ethereum. Anyway, with that aside, let's click on confirm. Close this. We wait for our one pending transaction to go through. And there it is. We can view it on the Harmony Explorer if we want. But you can see now my balance of the one USDT is 0.116 and my one token has reduced by 2. So now that you know how to swap, there's one more important thing that I want to show you, and that's how to earn some passive income with the crypto assets that you own.
Here's a quick question for you. What is your favorite decentralized exchange on the Harmony One network? Is it ViperSwap or something else? Let me know in the comments section below.
So from this exchange, you can go to the staking section. And here you'll be able to see all the different pairs of tokens that you can deposit and stake on this platform to make passive income. So there's some crazy gains that you can make, but it comes with a lot of risks also. So it depends on what you want to do. But from my experience, if you have coins that you believe will go up together or go down together, then it's a pretty good idea to deposit them here and earn a lot of yield. So you can see here, this is almost 5,000% gains per year. So that's pretty much 50x. So if you deposit $1 worth of these tokens, then you have $50 12 months later. But this is not financial advice. You need to do your own research here. But I just wanted to get your feet wet and give you an introduction in this video. If you're looking for more variety and want to stake your other assets like Bitcoin, Ethereum, or other altcoins as well, then it is a good idea to take advantage of these platforms, which I'm about to show you here. Plus, you can get a free sign-up bonus worth $375. So I think it's a no-brainer here. You simply just have to go to the links in the description below, sign up for these platforms, and start staking your crypto to earn your standard APY and the free bonus. You can see here through my links, BlockFi will give you a $250 bonus when you stake your crypto with them. And Celsius Network is going to be a $50 bonus. Crypto.com is also not bad at $25. Same thing with Ledn at $25. And lastly, Voyager is going to be $25 as well. My favorites, which I use for the long term, are BlockFi, Celsius Network, and Crypto.com. But Ledn and Voyager are still worthwhile signing up and getting their bonus.
If you want more information and more ways to earn passive income through your cryptocurrency assets, then I strongly recommend you go to this next video here. But if you still want more help on MetaMask, like connecting it to other wallets and dApps, or possibly even connecting to different blockchains other than Harmony One, then I have a playlist here of all the MetaMask videos so you can pick the right one for you. So check it out, and I'll see you over in the next tutorial.